Afternoon, friends. I hope you're all doing well. I'm also fine. So today I'm going to create a new video on how to copy RDS from one AWS account to another one. So I have a RDS on one of my accounts, and I want to copy this database, MySQL RDS database, to a different AWS account. And I'm going to do that with AWS sharing options. So let's get started. First of all, this is my source database, source RDS. This is the source account. And I'm going to shift this RDS to a different account or copy this RDS into a different account. So first, I will click here and then I will go for create a snapshot. This snapshot I will create, that's the snapshot of today. That means 09 August. Take a snapshot. Okay. This snapshot will take some time, and let's say 2 or 3 minutes. After the snapshot is ready, then I will share this snapshot with this account. So I copy this account ID here. This is the account ID. Okay. Then when it is ready, I will share this snapshot to the other account. So it might take some time, I think 1 or 2 minutes. So let's be patient on that. And when it is done, the status will be successful or green. Then we can share the snapshot. Okay. While it's being done, let me discuss why I'm going to do this. Because I want to copy this account to another account as a kind of like replica, and I will set up or copy all those databases over there. If I do it manually, like connected to the RDS via MySQL Workbench and then export and then import, that's a whole lot of complicated process. And if the database size is quite big, let's say the database size is around 500 gigabytes or maybe 1 terabyte, then it's a huge process. Probably you have to download 1 terabyte data into local and then you need to upload that to a new RDS. That's quite a long time. And based on your internet speed, it can take up to 6 or 8 hours. But the process that I am showing, it's very simple. It's very easy and can be done within 5 minutes. You don't need to copy any sort of anything manually. All things should be done inside the AWS, and there is no chance of data loss. That's the important part, that all the data will be copied exactly as it is to the point I am writing. So let's say you have a development database and you want to copy it to the production. You can use this, you can do this using this process. Also, maybe sometimes you need to take a backup of your main database and analyze into a different account for different kind of reports generation. That is also can be achieved using this process. And it is very easy and simple. So we just need to wait for 2 or 3 minutes. Yeah, it's available now. That's great. So my snapshot is done. I'm going to click here. And then in the actions button, I will click share snapshots. I will share this snapshot with a different AWS account. So private, and I'm going to give the account ID. That's the account ID. Save. Okay. So I shared. Now I go here, and if I go to snapshots and then shared with me, you will see this is the snapshot that has been shared with me. So I'm going to do is click here. Actions, restore snapshot. That's the point. This is loading, so it will give me the options to restore. I will use MySQL. Give me a name here. WP tips, VPC same, public access, yes. VPC security group default, that's fine. I'm going to use three tier. So let's include T2 micro. That's within false, within the free tier. I keep everything as it is. Encryption, that's fine. Additional database options and enable deletion protection. That means I cannot delete this accidentally. That is really helpful and a small tip that can save a lot of your time in future. Maybe sometimes you just click the delete button and your RDS is gone. That shouldn't happen because you have this enable deletion protection and you need to uncheck this to delete that RDS. That means if you keep this on, you will not be able to delete that from the interface. Okay, this is a small tip, but it's really helpful. So restore DB instances. Click here. Okay, so its status is creating. That means it takes time, I think 2 or 3 minutes again. And then when it is done, I will have a status successful. And I will see my new RDS created, which is exactly backup of that particular time. That's amazing feature from AWS. I think I just shared with you that saves a lot of time for of your normal data migration process. And if your data size is quite big, I would suggest always use this process to avoid any kind of data loss or time consumptions, etc. So we just need to wait for 1 or 2 minutes here. It should be ready. Sometimes it takes around 5 minutes. So what I can do is just pause the video. Okay, so I am back and it seems that the database instance restoration is completed. It's available. So that means we have successfully copied the database from one account to another and we just did nothing. It's more not more than 5 to 10 minutes work. And it's basically the time is taken just to copy and reinstantiate, but we just did it with few clicks, 5 or 6 clicks. So I hope this helps you to restore database from one account to another. And if the data size is big, this is a very helpful process. Thank you for watching my video and please subscribe to my channel to see more tips on AWS. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.